Hello guys, and welcome to today's tutorial, in which we're going to learn to convert this image into a metallic color, something like this. So let's get started. First of all, we need to make a selection of the subjects. So the best way to do that is to go to the select option and select subject. You'll be amazed to find how perfectly Photoshop selects the subject. So let's move on to the next step. Let's click the Add a Mask button sitting at the bottom of the Layers panel, which will create a mask of the selection. Now let's select the mask and then right-click and select the Apply Layer Mask option. At this point, you'll find that we have isolated the subject and there's no background that was there earlier because we never needed it, so we removed it by applying the layer mask. Now we need to add a dark background to this image, so let's go to Create New Filler Adjustment Layer option and select the Solid Color option from here, which shall open a color picker. Drag the picker to the extreme bottom left corner to pick the black color and hit OK. You'll find the screen turning black, and it's black because this layer is sitting on top of the subject layer. So let's drag it under the subject layer and you'll find the subject layer revealing itself. Next, let's select the subject layer and go to Image and then Adjustments and select the Desaturate option, which will convert the subject into a grayscale image. It's time to make a copy of our subject layer. So with the layer selected, hit Command J on a Mac or Control J on a PC, and the layer shall be duplicated. With the topmost layer selected, change its blending mode to Difference. This blending mode is used to perfectly align layers. It lines up nearly identical layers because the colors subtract from each other, resulting in greater brightness value. With the topmost layer still selected, let's go to Image and then Adjustments and select Invert. And you can now find how the highlights are further highlighted, creating a metallic effect already. Let's now merge the top two layers, and to do that, holding Command on a Mac or Control on a PC, click to select both the layers and then right-click and select the Merge Layers option. At this point, our image is looking more like a metallic silver, so it's time to add some colors to it. So with the topmost layer selected, let's go to Create New Filler Adjustment Layer option at the bottom of the Layers panel and select the Gradient Map option, which will apply the last used color to the image. Click anywhere on the gradient to populate the gradient editor. From the different preset gradient color options, you can experiment and choose the one you like. I'm going to use shades from the orange folder here. So let's pick this one. Here we can do further adjustments to the color used in the gradient. I'm going to move my red to the left and yellow to the right by moving the sliders accordingly. You can see that the gradient, for obvious reasons, has been applied to the whole image, which includes the background. But that's not what I wanted. I want the gradient to be applied only to the subject and not to the background. So to do that, you see this small button here. Clicking this button will clip the gradient to the layer just below it, which is the subject layer in our case. So here comes the magic. You see how the gradient has been clipped to the subject. So now all we need to do is fine-tune our colors for a perfect metallic color. I can take help of the opacity option here and reduce the opacity to about half. If not happy with the colors yet, we can further play with the blending modes. So let's try a different blending mode. Let's use Vivid Light from here. And voila, we have successfully transformed our image to a metallic finish. Hope you've learned something new today and have enjoyed this tutorial. So do like, share, and subscribe to the channel. Until we meet again, goodbye, and thanks for watching.